boys in the back.
So what we're going to do here, from here, is we're going to hit upstream. We'll be on the boat for anywhere from 45 minutes to an hour, and then just make the rest up as we go. Just a few things to go through with regard to our time on board the boat. When we're travelling, the obvious one, stay seated, but also keep arms inside of the boat. We will stop. That then enables me an opportunity to make up stories. What I'm able to do on occasions to stop is I can spin the boat between 180 and 360. It's because I can. It's fun. I'll give you guys heaps of warning before doing one of those. I'll give two signals. The first one I'll give is this. I'll also give an indication as to which way the boat will spin, and all you need to do for it, hold on, I'll take care of the rest. I've just spoken to Michelle, aspiring helicopters. Davey, the pilot, just been up.
All good?
Thanks.
So you guys are going to get a rip of flight. You're going to be gobsmacked. Okay. What's good about being here now, from your perspective as visitors? These trees on the riverbanks, 3 weeks ago, basically had no colour.
Right. Yeah.
So spring is sprung.
Really? Wow.
Yeah. It's really starting to happen. In about another 6 weeks, what snow there is still up there on the hills, that will melt. But these mountains we're sort of seeing now, or parts of them we're seeing now, they're only just small mountains. Once we poke our nose up around the corner away as we get amongst the big ones, you'll soon understand why I'm calling these the small ones. But what's up on the big ones, a lot of that's ice, and it stays put. Regardless of the time of year too.